Hi guys, have you been wanting different types of poetry that is in the English literature? Don't go anywhere, as I'm going to bring to you the different types of poetry. I'm also going to teach how to identify any type of poetry. Sonnets. Sonnets is a 14-line poem that usually do on love. There are two types of sonnets, the Petrarch sonnet and Shakespearean sonnet, also called the English sonnet. The difference between these two types of sonnets is in the number of the stanzas and the rhyme pattern. The Petrarch sonnet has two stanzas, whereas the Shakespearean sonnet has four stanzas, arranged in three quatrains and one couplet. Quatrain is a stanza that has four lines, and couplet is a verse that has two lines. Petrarch sonnet has ABBA CDE CDE rhyme pattern. ABBA CDE CDE rhyme pattern. Whereas Shakespearean or English sonnet has the rhyme pattern of ABAB CDCD EFEF GG. The second type of poetry we're going to consider is elegy. Elegy is a poem that is written in mournful periods, like in case of death or loss. Elegy can be written for a particular person, and it can also be written to treat the general topic of death or general topic of loss. One thing about elegy is that it doesn't have a particular rhyme pattern like you have in sonnets. Another one we'll consider is epigram. Epigram is a short, witty, and often satirical poem that is arranged either in couplets or in quatrain. I already explained what couplet is and what quatrain is. Couplet simply means a verse that has two lines, and quatrain is a verse that has four lines. A witty poem is a poem that is both clever and amusing. A satirical poem is a poem that talks about the ills of the society. So epigram is a poem that has any of these qualities embedded in it. That is short, clever, amusing, or could also be talking about the ills of the society. The next one we're going to consider is limerick. Limerick is a poem that offers laugh. The sole objective of limerick is just to make someone laugh. Limerick usually has five lines and a rhyme pattern of AABBA. In limerick, the first two lines are usually long. The following two lines are usually shorter than the first two lines. And the last line, which is the fifth line, is as long as the first two lines. So the next one we'll consider is ballad. It's a folk poetry that tells a story that is meant to be sung and is usually transmitted from generation to generation orally. One thing about ballad is that the poem is usually arranged in quatrains. Another one we'll consider is epitaph. Epitaph is more like an elegy. It's a poem that's written on occasion of death or occasion of loss. The difference between elegy and epitaph is that epitaph is usually shorter than elegy. It's usually very short. An epitaph commonly appears on gravestones. Another one we'll look at is ode. Ode is a poem that addresses a particular person, thing, or event. It is believed to have been invented by the ancient Greeks who will sing their ode. But modern odes do not follow a regular pattern. An example of ode is the poem by Percy Shelley, Ode to the West Wind. Before I end this video, I want to say a very big thank you to those who have subscribed to this channel. You guys are the best. You encourage us to do more on this channel. Hi guys, have you been wondering the different types of poetry that is in the English literature? Don't go anywhere, as I'm going to bring to you the different types of poetry. I'm also going to teach how to identify any type of poetry. Sonnets. Sonnets is a 14-line poem that usually do on love. There are two types of sonnets, the Petrarch sonnet and Shakespearean sonnet, also called the English sonnet. The difference between these two types of sonnets is in the number of the stanzas and the rhyme pattern. The Petrarch sonnet has two stanzas, whereas the Shakespearean sonnet has four stanzas, arranged in three quatrains and one couplet. Quatrain is a stanza that has four lines, and couplet is a verse that has two lines. Petrarch sonnet has ABBA CDE CDE rhyme pattern. ABBA CDE CDE rhyme pattern. Whereas Shakespearean or English sonnet has the rhyme pattern of ABAB CDCD EFEF Gigi. The second type of poetry I'm going to consider is elegy. Elegy is a poem that is written in mournful periods, like in case of death or loss. Elegy can be written for a particular person, and it can also be written to treat the general topic of death or general topic of loss. One thing about elegy is that it doesn't have a particular rhyme pattern like you have in sonnets. Another one we'll consider is epigram. Epigram is a short, witty, and often satirical poem that is arranged either in couplets or in quatrain. I read the word couplet is and what quatrain is. Couplet simply means a verse that has two lines, and quatrain is a verse that has four lines. A witty poem is a poem that is both clever and amusing. A satirical poem is a poem that talks about the ills of the society. So epigram is a poem that has any of these qualities embedded in it. A short, clever, amusing, or could also be talking about the ills of the society. The next one we're going to consider is limerick. Limerick is a poem that offers laugh. The sole objective of limerick is just to make someone laugh. Limerick usually has five lines and a rhyme pattern of AABBA. In limerick, the first two lines are usually long. The following two lines are usually shorter than the first two lines. And the last line, which is the fifth line, is as long as the first two lines. The next one we'll consider is ballad. It's a folk poetry that tells a story that is meant to be sung and is usually transmitted from generation to generation orally. One thing about ballad is that the poem is usually arranged in quatrains. Another one we'll consider is epitaph. Epitaph is more like an elegy. It's a poem that's written on occasion of death or occasion of loss. The difference between elegy and epitaph is that epitaph is usually shorter than elegy. It's usually very short. An epitaph commonly appears on gravestones. Another one we'll look at is ode. Ode is a poem that addresses a particular person, thing, or event. It is believed to have been invented by the ancient Greeks who will sing their ode. But modern odes do not follow a regular pattern. An example of ode is the poem by Percy Shelley, Ode to the West Wind. Before I end this video, I want to say a very big thank you to those who have subscribed to this channel. You guys are the best. You encourage us to do more on this channel.